responds, turning back the tide of illegal robocalls, the promise written into a new law made official over the holidays.
Yeah, it gives the government power to kill those hated calls before they come through and to go after the people behind them. Lisa Parker's here with more. Lisa.
Patrick and Marion, thank you. And you are excused. If you did not hear much about this law passing, the day it was signed, right amidst the holidays and the impeachment furor, it was one of the few truly bipartisan developments in weeks. Passed overwhelmingly, what was a popular idea now moves on to its real test.
These days, if your cell phone is ringing.
Hello?
Hello.
There's 200 million unwanted calls every day in the United States.
Chances are really good, as high as 40%. It is a robocall. Annoying to you, yes, but lucrative for some callers.
The average fraud is $350 per call.
Numbers and damage that will dwindle if the newly passed TRACED Act does its job. It stands for Telephone Robocall Abuse, Criminal Enforcement and Deterrence, and requires phone companies to implement a number authentication system that will help identify who's calling, and that's at no extra cost to consumers. It also gives law enforcement more time to go after bad actors, extending the statute of limitations from 1 year to 4 years, and slaps rogue robocallers with heavier fines, up to $10,000 per call.
Having a criminal penalty is a very strong deterrent.
A step in the right direction? Robocall expert Bill Verson says yes, but
I'll be honest with you. You know, the bad actors are always going to find a way to try to get around it.
He says you can bet robocallers are right now looking for the weaknesses.
But it's like the whack-a-mole game. You hit the whack-a-mole, you hit the mole, and it pops up someplace else.
So the great news, calls will go down. Not so awesome, it won't be anytime soon. Many smaller carriers have not yet upgraded their software, and the law gives them 18 months to comply.
So it's going to take some time, probably about 2 years, before you actually see the full benefits of it.
So, in other words, don't stop screening just yet. But there are highlights here. The law specifically says the federal government must put consumers first. That's right in the text. Another highlight, it requires major carriers to weed out calls from any number that is spoofed. As you probably know, that's a favorite go-to for scammers when they make it look like the call is coming from a trusted source or something really close to your number.
Yeah.
So, help is definitely on the way. Well, this was a long time coming. But we can't hold our or let our
Not
guards
just yet.
Down just yet.
Yeah. Okay.
Hopefully it works.
Good to know something's on the
That's
horizon.
Right. That's progress.
Thanks, Lisa.
You're welcome.